All right, let's start by the beginning, and let's start by creating our first simple class. We're going to be working on an example where we're going to be creating classes that represent people, all right? And remember, keep this in mind, whenever we define classes, what we are defining is the general template or the general pattern that all person objects are going to be following. So whether if they all have age, name, blah, 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 and what kind of functionality they do have, all right? This is what we do when we define classes. So the way to define a class in a console application, for example, is that we need to go all the way outside to the most parent scope. That is at the same level where we have this other thing called a program class. Oh, this is suspicious. Wait, console applications are actually program classes. What does that mean? I'll get to that farther down in the videos, okay? But we need to go back to this same level. And the idea is that we create classes by using this structure called classes, all right? So the way that works is that I'm going to write the word class here, and I'm going to write the name of that I want to give to this class. I'm going to call it person, all right? And then I'm going to open and close curly brackets, and then I'm going to leave it like that. Now, that's it. That's the only thing, that's the baseline that I need to create classes that represent people. Obviously, this is going to be empty right now, so people are going to have no properties whatsoever, but I will get to how that works and how we add more properties in the next video, all right? What I want to show you is that this is the actual class. So this is representing the idea, the template. I'm going to write here template for person objects, all right? But now, anytime that I want to create a person object, so one copy with particular data of this overall idea of a person, what I need to create is an object. And the way to do that is by saying, I'm going to define something that is going to be called Jose Luis, all right? It's going to be a variable. And this variable is going to store a new object of the type person. The way that works is that we have to use this other keyword that we haven't seen yet, which is called the new keyword. I write here the name of the class that I'm going to be using. I'm going to open and close parentheses, and I'm going to put a semicolon here. What I'm doing with this is that I'm saying, hey, person class, can you give me a new object of yourself? So imagine the car factory example that I just explained. Imagine that this is kind of like calling the factory and saying like, hey, can you give me a car? And then they send your way a car with a particular shape, particular colors, whatever, all right? So the new keyword is what we use to ask for new instantiations of this class, AKA to ask for objects, all right? So Jose Luis is going to be an object of the type person. But I get an error here, and the error is that the name Jose Luis doesn't exist, blah, blah, blah. It's basically telling me that if this is a variable, I need to give it a type, all right? Because this variable doesn't have a type right now. But what is the type of this variable? Is it going to be a Boolean, a string? What is this going to be for a type, right? We don't know what that type is. What actually happens when we work with object programming, object-oriented programming, is that classes, the classes that we define, become new types that we can use for our variables. So Jose Luis is not going to be a string, it's not going to be a Boolean, it's not going to be an integer. It's actually going to be a person. So this variable is not going to be of the type string, it's going to be of the type person, actually, all right? So people are, if I create new objects from the person class, they're actually of the type person. And this is very interesting because creating classes not only means data, complex data structure, etc., but it also means creating new data types that our programs can understand, that they can manipulate, and that they can use to talk to each other, all right? So by creating classes, we also implicitly are creating new types for variables, which is super, super neat, all right? All right, so, but now what is going on with Jose Luis? Well, if I actually print Jose Luis to the console and I run this program, you're going to see that it just gives me nothing. Basically, what it gives me is that I have something of the type person that belongs to this file that I'm using here, which is kind of not great because basically Jose Luis right now contains nothing, right? So let's see on the next video, how can we add properties? How can we add variables to these objects, to this class? Like for example, name, age, etc., etc. Let's take a look at how that works.